If you're working on a project that requires vinyl, pleather, or cork, don't fret. While these materials may seem a little intimidating if you don't have a lot of experience working with them, you simply need to make a few minor adjustments. Just using the right needle, thread, and understanding the material will be all that you need to sew successfully with these fabrics. The tools you sew with can make a big difference. Consider swapping out your regular needle for a super non-stick universal needle. These needles have a coating on them that will glide through the material and are especially useful if you have a tacky stabilizer underneath. If you're sewing through a particularly heavy pleather or vinyl material, you can also switch to a leather needle. Leather needles are designed for piercing through these particularly resistant materials. You can also change your presser foot for a non-stick or Teflon presser foot when sewing on pleather or vinyl. These materials can stick to the bottom of a regular presser foot, which impacts your stitch quality. A non-stick foot has a super slick surface that prevents that from happening. If you don't have a non-stick presser foot or they aren't available for your machine model, you can also use a walking foot. These feet are designed to provide a second set of feed dogs from the top of the fabric, which helps to push these specialty materials through. The thread that you sew with is also important to think about. Because cork, pleather, and vinyl are much thicker, you'll want to use a stronger thread to keep them together, especially if the project you have in mind requires some durability. Home Deck is an enhanced polyester thread designed for extra strength. It comes in three weights, 30 weight, 40 weight, and 60 weight. Because this thread is so strong, we don't recommend using a normal bobbin thread with it. Always use the 60 weight Home Deck in the bobbin when you're using any weight of Home Deck in the top. The slightly lighter weight thread will help reduce the seam bulk, which is especially useful when dealing with thicker materials. On your sewing machine, consider increasing the stitch length slightly. With pleather, vinyl, and cork, you'll be piercing the material with permanent holes. Having the stitch length too short means the holes will be closer together, causing damage to the material and compromising its strength. Since you'll be sewing with an enhanced strength thread like Home Deck, the thread will easily compensate for holding together your seams even with the longer stitch length. Because the holes pierced through these materials are permanent, you won't be able to use pins without leaving ugly holes behind. You can instead hold your pieces together using Wonder Clips. These will pinch your materials together without needing to put a hole in them. What about if you need to clip something that isn't close enough to the edge, such as an applique? Unfortunately, many pleather and vinyl materials will melt even on very low heat, making it impossible to use an iron-on applique. Take some Scotch tape and tape over the applique pieces so they don't shift. You can then stitch through the tape and around the applique with a straight or decorative stitch to hold it down permanently. Afterwards, pull away the bits of tape to clean it up. Since you can't use an iron on pleather and vinyls, we recommend using a seam roller to help press your seams. This tool is a must for any material that can't be ironed, and it is much more effective than simply finger pressing open a seam. We hope these tips make it easier for you to sew with these specialty fabrics. If you're making a project with vinyl, pleather, or cork, let us know in the comment section below. Or let us know what type of video you'd like to see next time. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up if you like this video, or hit subscribe for more great tips and tutorials. We'll see you all next time.